Welcome to CaseWare QuickVids. This QuickVid demonstrates how the firm can manage their note disclosure content and easily highlight changes and updates to staff in CaseWare Financials. Financials has a content management system for notes and lets a template author define the status for each note. These include out of date, new, expired, and effected after. These statuses help ensure that end users are properly informed about the content in their client files compared to that of the organization's content knowledge library. As the template author updates the status in the content management section for each note, there are mechanisms in the financial statements that help a user evaluate their content to the organization's standards. To access the note content management system when in the firm note library, click the Show Content Management Options button. You can also click Document Content Management, Show Content Management Options. I will start by demonstrating how to create updated versions of firm-created note content. In the Notes to the Financial Statements library, there are several cache notes. This QuickVid assumes that this is the second year of CaseWare Financials implementation in the organization. The template author has decided to review existing notes to the current standards and create new notes if necessary. The template author has reviewed the restricted cache note and determined that it needs to be updated to meet the current standards. Any edits to note content require you to increase the version number so that users can identify that the note has changed. By default, the version number is 1.0. While not necessary, you can also increment the last modified date. In the version field, type the new version number of the note. Click the button at the right of the last modified field. From the calendar that appears, select the date on which the note was modified. The note content has been updated and the version number has been incremented. I will now demonstrate how this will affect financial statements in client files. I'm going to open an existing client file that was created in a previous year. In the Notes to the Financial Statements section, you will recognize the restricted cache note from the Notes library. Recall we modified the text of the restricted cache note and the firm has moved the version number up? In the Client Financial Statements, I want to know if the firm has made any modifications that will affect my client file. Financials include a highlighting option, which is a really convenient way to see the status of my notes compared to the knowledge library. To enable highlighting indicators, from the Content Management tab, click Highlight. Notice a yellow warning icon appears beside the restricted cache note. You can mouse over the icon to learn more. For more information on other highlighting indicators, see our online help. This icon informs staff that a note in their financial statements has an updated version in the knowledge library. The decision is left to the staff whether the note should be updated or replaced. I'm going to demonstrate updating the note. From the Content Management tab, click Check for Updates. Check for Updates will not only check for updated notes, but also any other statement formats that have been modified in the libraries. Examine the list of client file updates that has been created. For this demonstration, we are only interested in the restricted cache note. Select the restricted cache note and click OK. Depending on the settings defined by the template author, a visual merge dialog may appear. For more information, refer to the QuickVid Knowledge Libraries overview. This dialog provides the opportunity to retain customizations that may not otherwise be retained, such as new columns added in a do-it-yourself table. I'm going to click OK to close the dialog. In the Visual Merge dialog, you're able to view, accept, or modify existing content with aspects of new content. In this demonstration, the firm change will be used as is, so I'll click Close to accept the update. The client file is updated to include the latest content. I will now demonstrate creating a new note and marking it as such in the content management frame. In this demonstration, a new cache note will be added to the library. Please see the QuickVid Creating Alternative Formats for Notes for more details on adding new notes to the firm library. After the new cache note is added, the template author should mark in the Content Management section New. When staff are working in the client financial statements, they will have the option to browse for new notes and determine if they are relevant to their engagement. Now, let's see how new note content can be viewed in client files. In the Content Management tab, click New. In this view, you are able to browse all new notes. Notice there are numerous new CaseWare notes, but navigating to cash and cash equivalents, you will see the new cash in and cash equivalent note I created previously. Any of these notes can be inserted if it is applicable for the current financial statements. I am going to click OK to close the dialog inserting the note. I will now demonstrate how to expire old firm content and demonstrate how this affects engagement files. Looking at the cash and cash equivalent notes, the template author has compared the content of this note to the relevant standards and determined that it should be expired. In this case, the template author sets the note as expired and optionally enters the date the note expires. Once the date of expiration has passed, you will no longer be able to insert this note into the financial statements unless the template author has selected Use After, in which case you can still use the note, but it will be highlighted as expired. Notes are not automatically removed in the client files unless it was auto-generated and the Add Remove Recommended Content option is selected, as a note may have other engagement-specific modifications. For more information on the Add Remove Recommended Content, refer to the online help. Select Expired. Click the button at the right of the expiry date field. From the calendar that appears, select a date that the note is to expire. If the note is to be available for use after the expiry date, select Use After. Now let's see how you can view expire notes in client files. In the Content Management tab, click Highlight. Notice a red icon beside the note. This informs the user that the template author has marked the note as expired, and the user needs to take appropriate action. Alternatively, you can browse all expired notes by clicking on the Expire button in the Content Management tab. I will now demonstrate how the Effective After option can be used to advise users of upcoming standard changes and demonstrate how users can view these notes in client files. Template authors may populate the note library with content before standards are effective so that users can choose early adoption. These notes can be marked with the Effective After flag. Select the Effective After checkbox to mark the note as effective after a specified date or fiscal period. If the note is to be effective after a specified date or fiscal period, click the button to the right of the date field. From the calendar that appears, select the date that the note is to be effective after. We are going to review how these options will appear in client files. Back in the financial statements, on the Content Management tab, clicking Effective After will display any notes set as effective after and list the effective date or effective fiscal date. When implemented, the Note Content Management System is an invaluable tool to the template author and user. The assistance it provides in the preparation or review of content gives users peace of mind that they are producing financial statements that meet the standards. This concludes the QuickVid on Content Management and CaseWare Financials. For additional resources, including documentation and online help, see the related links. Thank you for watching CaseWare QuickVids.